We all know how to use a Windows PC at its core, but on these great touchscreen devices we call Surface, we have tablet mode, and that makes it a lot easier to navigate through Windows using touch.
Absolutely. I adore tablet mode for when we want that touch-first experience, which, let's be clear, is not always. But sometimes as we're on the go, it's really great. So to do this, I'm going to be dramatic. I'm going to take my type cover and rip it off. I don't need it because this is tablet mode. And I'm also going to recline my Surface Pro into what we call studio mode, physically, of course. Now, you still see it in desktop mode. So how I'm going to get to tablet mode, I'm going to swipe in from the right side of my screen. That brings us back into Action Center. And then I will toggle it with this button you see right here, tablet mode. Now, look at what happens once I enter into tablet mode. It changes dramatically. Now, if you're thinking this looks a little bit like Windows 8, you're not wrong. It is full screen with the live tiles front and center, but it's available to you as an option now, of course. So I can see those live tiles that I've chosen to pin because they're important to me. And if I'm forgetting something, I can simply press this button right here, which is all apps. And now I have that exact same alphabetic list of all the apps on my computer. This also includes, yes, of course, Paint and everything else I'm used to, but now full screen.
The full start menu really is still there available for you.
Exactly, anything that you want to use. Now, as I'm going through this, the live tiles are front and center, but I actually did have some things running a little bit earlier. So how can I see what I'm currently using on the computer? Well, that is a feature called Task View, and everything about tablet mode is about the edges of the screen. Keep that in mind. So I can get into my Task View mode by swiping in from the left-hand side of the screen. And just like that, I'm able to see the apps that I'm using now, as well as my history of usage down in my timeline. So I can go ahead and tap the internet, and here is Microsoft Edge. I can swipe and tap again and switch to Microsoft Teams and all the different things that I want to use, including a good old-fashioned file folder. Now, we've had this since the dawn of computing, but now in tablet mode, the file folder modifies itself. How do you select multiple things in a folder? If you're thinking control click right now, that is correct, but how do I hold control with no keyboard? So you'll notice there's little nice check boxes that we have made available here. Everything on this side column has a little bit more padding so I can easily press it with my finger. How do you can copy things, paste things, select everything in a folder? Those are all popular keyboard combinations. So what we've done is we've put them here at the top of the folder. So I have nice, easily clickable buttons, including one for select all. All of these nice, familiar tools. Now, how do you close something in tablet mode? Say I don't want this folder running anymore. Take your finger from the very top of your Surface and pull down. That puts it in your grasp, and now its fate is in your hands. If you continue your path of destruction down to the bottom of the screen, that completely closes the application. Not running anymore. Look, I'll swipe into Task View, nothing up my sleeve, it's gone. Now, what if I don't want to completely close something? Instead, I want to run two things at once. So I'm going to pull down from the top of my screen. Instead of going to the bottom, I'm going to now move it to one side or the other. Now, as I do this, you see there's that bar chasing me across the screen that's letting me know, hey, when you let go, we're going to snap it. Just like that, Windows 10 understands I don't want to simply admire my desktop background over there. I want to do something else. So it gives me a miniature version of Task View. So I can simply select, let's say, Microsoft Teams and put that over there on the side. Teams is responsive and automatically adjusts itself, giving me a nice view on both. So I'm able to scroll and scroll here and use it kind of like my mobile command center, seeing everything I want at the same time. Now, if I don't like this view, I simply grab that bar in the middle and push it all the way off to one side. That's also how you can resize the different items on your screen as you are using them.
Now, another thing that you'll notice here on tablet mode, at the taskbar at the very bottom, all of our icons have disappeared, and they haven't been removed. They're still there if we switch out of tablet mode, but the reason we've removed them for this mode specifically is to make it easier to hold your device with one hand, still navigate, without the fear of opening new applications that you don't necessarily want to at the time.
Exactly.
We've also included a back button there as well, so if you're in the web and you're browsing, it becomes really easy, muscle memory, to just press that back button in the bottom left corner, so it just makes navigating through File Explorer, Edge, and other browsers as well, more natural experience with touch.
when you exit tablet mode. It's not a fundamental shift. You're not using a different computer. It's the same computer. So I want to show you what that looks like. Let's say I'm in the middle of using some different applications. So I'll go ahead and open Teams here on the side. And I'll move that over to the right-hand side. We'll split that with Microsoft Edge. And then now I want to exit tablet mode. Well, there's a couple of ways. Once you reattach your type cover to your Surface, or if you're using a Surface Book 2, if you reattach your base, it might prompt you. Or if it doesn't, you can simply swipe in from the right side of the screen again and toggle tablet mode off. Now watch what happens when I do this. Not much, and that's exactly the point. Now you'll notice I have my close, maximize, and minimize buttons back at the top of my different apps. When I hit start, I get my nice compact and familiar start menu, so it's right back where I was. All in all, it's a simple addition to change the user interface slightly so that you're able to use your device more effectively while you're on the go.